This field door was the first batch of paint that I got to color these pieces with, but it was not a good match. I had to go back and have them do it again, have them mix it up again. It came out kind of a more reddish and a lighter color, and it did not a good match. So I put all these pieces back down there, and they matched it up. First they used a scanner that reads the color, and it didn't do such a good job, but the second batch that they mixed up looks like it's going to be a real winner. I don't have a regular tack cloth. I need one to get the dust. I'm just going to have to use a wet cloth and then let it dry. I have a damp cloth. I wrung it out pretty tight, so cloth like this is always going to have dust, whether it's damp or not, but at least there won't be any static for the dust to stick. Hopefully we'll get enough of it off. But these are not going to be shiny parts anyway. It's a semi-gloss paint, and then it's got that rough vinyl appearance to it. So.
My vent hole is right here. Of course, you could turn this thing any way you want to. That's my vent hole. There's a pointer on top. I want that facing me so that paint doesn't run out of there. I shouldn't let the paint get up onto the top of this anyway, but it might. Now I have to adjust my spray pattern. Add a little too much. I hope we're okay. This one is not gonna paint good. It's rejecting it, so. Gonna wipe that off and start over. Little rejection here too. Got a lot of rejection. Got to wipe all of it off and start over. I don't have enough paint for all this. This part is the front of the fender, so I really want that to be about as good as I can get it. That's the back of the fender. I'm not as worried about that. That won't show.